Starting next month, some people who are caught driving with a suspended license will be treated differently than others. The change in law comes after the Cumberland County District Attorney told lawmakers her office couldn't handle the caseload because she doesn't have enough resources. News 8's Keith Baldy is live in Portland with this News 8 exclusive. And good evening to you, Keith.
Good evening, Tori. Every day, police arrest people on the roadways for driving with suspended licenses. But soon, the law will change, and some of those people will get a ticket instead. And that is not sitting well with everyone. The number of suspended license cases were skyrocketing here in Cumberland County, and the district attorney says she didn't have the resources to handle them all. So she went to the legislature and asked for some relief. The solution, says Representative Ann Haskell, was to decriminalize operating after suspension in certain cases.
This was a place where common sense began to prevail when we began to look at the reality of what was actually happening.
What was actually happening, according to Haskell and the DA, was that less serious first offense cases were treated as simple traffic offenses with a fine. So they figured, why not change the law and have police hand out tickets instead of arresting people?
And in these critical economic times, it was important to look at what was the balance there between public safety and the wise use of resources.
The new law, which takes effect September 12th, only applies in cases where the suspension is a result of unpaid fines, failing to pay license reinstatement fees, or because someone bounced a check to the state. Minor infractions to some, but part of the law nonetheless to others.
I just think we're moving in the wrong direction.
Westbrook Police Chief William Baker wonders if the state decriminalizes driving after suspension because of budget problems, what's next? And Baker believes it sends a message to scofflaws that repeatedly ignoring rules is okay.
The people that are being cut the slack are the people that are inclined to break the rules. And those are the people that we ought to be holding responsible for their bad behavior to try and gain voluntary compliance and reduce the level of non-compliance. And I don't think we reduce the level of non-compliance by giving them a break.
Representative Haskell says changing this law does not mean others will automatically follow, but she says if someone comes in with a good idea, they certainly will entertain it. Live in Portland, Keith Baldy, News 8.
An update tonight in the case of a former Buxton couple charged 2 years ago with animal cruelty. John and Heidi Fresca appeared separately this afternoon in Biddeford District Court, the judge entering not guilty pleas on both of their behalves. Back in August 2007, animal health officials raided their Buxton kennel, seizing nearly 250 dogs, one of the largest raids on an animal breeding facility in this state's history. Both are charged with 25 criminal counts of animal cruelty. In the wake of the customer complaints, billing problems, and long waits for customer service, FairPoint Communications' top boss was in the hot seat today, forced to answer some tough questions. News 8's Jim Keithley attended today's hearing in Augusta. He joins us now with a closer look at what the company had to say. Jim.
Well, Tori, stunning revelations today as the head of FairPoint Communications admits the company is in big trouble. There are concerns it may go bankrupt if it can't fix the computer systems that have plagued them for months now. And they need to win back consumer trust. That won't be easy, with FairPoint posting a second quarter loss of nearly $18 million.
And it is a stressful time.
The problems are so bad, the president of FairPoint himself, front and center, saying the company has made some strides, but more needs to be done.
We have a very high degree of urgency to address the needs of the customer, and we're doing it today.
The problem, the company says, began when it took over Verizon's operations in Maine, New Hampshire, and Vermont back in February. The company admits now the changeover was more involved than originally thought, meshing the two companies' computer systems, more than 600 of them, proving to be a massive headache.
In the beginning, we knew there were going to be some problems. I think it's very fair to say at this point that there were more problems than we thought.
Customers, legislators, even the state's public advocate concerned about safety and an economic meltdown if the landlines and broadband internet service don't work. They cite one instance where FairPoint service shut down.
The large majority of the population of Houlton couldn't call its own hospital.
Bottom line is that there comes a point where we need to have a safety net of public safety coverage for landline service here in Maine. And if we don't have that, we're going to have to figure out a way to get it.
The key thing here is that everybody wants to be in the same place. everybody is in agreement with where we want to end up, and that's with a company that has systems that function, that's providing more broadband to the state, is doing the things that we said we were going to do.
Now, FairPoint and the state of Maine have a lot at stake here. The company has 1.5 million access lines in the three states it serves. 550,000 of those lines are here in Maine. Any computer system upgrade could take another 6 months. And the company's president says he's confident independent consultants can figure out the problems and get them fixed. Live in the newsroom, Jim Keithley, News 8.